What up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. We're gonna be working on the TSX today. I've been neglecting it for a while. You know, since the car is lowered and everything, the axles give out. And yeah, they start shaking from like 30 to 40 miles per hour, you know, and then just shakes at high speed as well. So what I did was purchase a set of axles from Raxles. I got them a couple years ago. I just never had the time to put them on. I always went back to like Advance or O'Reilly's to swap them out. But yeah, these are like OEM replacements. And the guy at Raxles, he made a set of axles for the TSX. Let me show you what it is. Raxles. I went with Raxles because I heard about them a long time ago for like my DA and stuff. They make axles for that, for the notorious shaking. So yeah, I forgot how much I paid for them, but hit Marty up at Raxles.com or just look it up on Google. So since I'm changing the axles out, I want to change the I got a set of upper control arms and lower control arms as well. I have had this car for almost 10 years now, and I put like over 100,000 miles on it, so I'm gonna just go ahead and change these out as well. The lower control arms and the upper control arms. Since I'm doing the control arms as well, I'm gonna go ahead and replace the rotors and the brakes all the way around. So yeah, let's get to that. Working on a TSX. See, it's not that low, but it's slow enough to get those vibrations. So next thing I'm gonna do is pretty much take everything apart. Gotta get the axle off. Gotta get the rotors, the pads, the calipers off. I'm replacing the upper control arm, the lower control arm right here. I'll take all that shit off on both sides. So I'm gonna just do a quick lapse. Yeah, it's too much to do. All right, you guys, here are the old axles. Top one is the driver side. This is the passenger side. This is where your vibration is going to be coming from and your shakiness. So what happened is, when your Honda or your front wheel drive car is lowered, you know, your axles go in an angle. And what happened is, this is the inside where this goes to the half shaft or the intermediate shaft, whatever you want to call it. And the bearings inside rub onto this coupler, axle hub. And that's where you get your, you know, your shaking from. So if you was to cut this open and, you know, clean it up and look inside, you'll actually see markings, you know, from the bearing rubbing onto the to the hub. So that being said, the driver's side is probably okay, because I just changed it out anyway. But yeah, I had these on for, you know, a couple of don't know, probably like a year or two, but normally I change them out like every 6 months, or probably once a year, depending on how you drive. So as you can see, look at how freaking weak that joint is from all that stress and all that stress in the car. Yeah, if you guys can afford, you know, some Raxles, I think, I want to say I paid like $400 or $450 for both. If you can find a set of OEM axles, that would, you know, brand new OEM axles, that would be nice too. But last time I checked, they were like $500 or $600 each. So I decided to go with these. What Marty does at Raxles, he takes your OEM shaft, I mean your OEM CV axle, and he rebuilt some, put new bearings and stuff on it. You can go with OEM, like I said, but I had OEM axles before, and you know, those lasted, you know, probably a couple years, or it depends on how you drive and, you know, stuff like that, how low you are. You can you know, rebuild your axle and it will fix the issue. Or just replacing this axle hub right here, put new bearings in, pack every grease, get a new cup. The amount of money to rebuild it, I just bought some Raxles. That all I had to do was send in my old ones and he rebuilt them. I got them back in a timely manner, probably like a week or so. All right, you guys, I got the new control arm in, the upper control arm. Got everything bolted up. New lower control arms. And a new CV axle. And new rotors and brakes. So go ahead and do the other side. Alright guys, so got both axles in, brakes and rotors all the way around, upper and lower control arms, it's done, it fixed the vibration issue, everything runs smooth. I actually took the car down to Florida, about a 5 hour drive. Back and forth, it's been a couple of weeks now. Everything is good, vibration's gone. So, you guys have this problem, this shaking problem, get you a set of OEM axles if you can afford it, or you go with Raxles like I did, and yeah. Car runs so much better now, so much smoother. So I hope this helped you guys out. And if you guys wanna see more TSX, if you guys want to see more stuff on the TSX or my other builds, stay tuned, subscribe, like, and got any questions, leave a comment. Peace out. See you later.